Today we're sharing with you a video that Matt and Riley made at the garage, trying to break down for you the basics of what motion control is. Take it away, guys!
Hi, I'm Matt.
And I'm Riley.
Welcome to the garage.
Today, we're going to talk about the basics of motion control.
So what is motion control?
Basically, motion control is an electronic system designed to move objects in a controlled way.
The object you move could be a camera, a light, your favorite alcoholic beverage, a taco. Whatever it is, as long as it's moved in a controlled way, that's motion control.
Some examples of motion control in image making include pan tilt heads, motorized sliders, turntables, even our six-axis robot, the Bolt. Motion control isn't limited to just the image-making world.
Other examples of motion control include CNC milling, 3D printers, or industrial automation in factories.
Most of the time, we use motion control for precise control over the camera or objects that we're filming.
It is also often used in the compositing of multiple shots together, where the actions have to line up perfectly. So how does it work?
In every motion control system, there are a few key components you need to understand. There's a computer controller, which is kind of the brain of it all. There's the motor driver, which the brain talks to. There's the motor, which is controlled by the driver. And then the motor physically moves your object. Here at the studio, we use Dragon Frame, player software, even an Arduino as the controller. So let's talk about the driver or amplifier, the thing physically controlling the motor.
This is the driver or amplifier. It receives a signal from the controller and then sends AC or DC current to the motor so it will spin in a controlled way. Next, you have the motor. We work with two types of motors. We work with servo motors and stepper motors.
Stepper motors are open loop, whereas servo motors are closed loop. What that means is that in a stepper motor, an open loop system, there's no feedback back from the motor to the controller. The stepper controller has no idea what the motor's actually doing, it only knows what it's telling the motor to do. Whereas with a closed loop system, like servos, the servo controller knows exactly where the motor is in time and space. So if the motor isn't where it's supposed to be, the controller can compensate.
This is important when deciding whether or not to use a servo or a stepper, because sometimes it's really important that your motor goes when it's supposed to and it's not blind to what actually happens. In general, steppers are cheaper, less powerful, and easier to control, while servos can go much faster, have much more power, and take a lot more setup time. Next, we get into drive mechanics. This is where we take the rotary motion of the motor to create motions on set. It can be another rotary motion, a rotational movement, or it can be a linear motion. The combination of these, you can create all kinds of rigs.
So to summarize, motion control is using motors to create repeatable movements on set.
What you move and how you move it is up to your imagination. You don't have to have a fancy six-axis robot to do great motion control work. Thank you so much for watching, and we hope you learned a lot about motion control in this episode. We'd like to show you a lot more, too.
And also, remember, whenever you're trying anything new, especially when it involves electricity or high-speed movement, exercise extreme caution because we are not responsible for anything you may do wrong.